Good morning. I'm Axel, your personal testing companion. I'm here to monitor you through the testing course so that your experience is fully recorded to be examined in the future. Before we start, it's important to understand that testing will be very dangerous, and I can't interfere with your testing experience to prevent any injuries or possible fatalities. Now that we've gotten the introduction out of the way, the testing will begin now. Tunnels can be pretty hard to latch onto, but you'll get the hang of it.
Welcome.
Yes! Level zero. This first test should be very simple. You'll figure it out. I believe in you. Yay! I knew you'd be able to. Most subjects experience overexhaustion from testing as hard as you just did, so here we have one of many rest areas designed for your health.
Welcome.
Feel free to take a nap or something.
One.
I won't watch. Another test done. I'm sure you're very excited to finish them all. You'll love what we have for you afterwards. You may have already noticed the Ecliptic Industries short-distance tunneling device. It's required to continue on to the next tests. Most subjects may hear the Ecliptic tunneling device. You did it! Tunnels can be really cool, but it's important that you understand the safety guidelines that come with it. I'll read them as we continue on to the rest of the test. Rule 1. You cannot place tunnels on metallic surfaces. Metals tend to repel tunnel technology. Rule 2. Not really a rule, but you shouldn't worry about falling from high altitudes. The weird things on your legs take up all the shock. Rule 3. Do not strain your arms. The device has a big kickback when you fire, so you don't want to break any bones or deal with the injuries. Rule 4. Do not touch the barrel of the gun or stick any fingers or any limbs into it. New level! Don't be intimidated by the size of the room. Velocity, or speed, is constant between two tunnels. For example, if your pencil happened to roll off your desk into a tunnel on the floor while your other tunnel was on a wall, it would fly out of it. Objects you may be carrying with the device will also retain their speed along with you. I should probably mention, if you're scared of heights, try not to hit yourself in the head from blowing your arms. Brain-dead subjects cannot test. We've tried it before. This chamber without any guidance. According to numerous psychological studies, this indicates that you are one of 5 out of 6 humans who have cognitive and analytical skills. I should warn you, as beautiful as the energy projectile may look, do not reach out to touch it. Seriously, it will kill you. Harder. After all, you're practically flying straight through them.
One,
been solving these chambers at a superior rate. That's a compliment. Anyways, to continue testing, you'll need to trade your tunneling device with a modified one in the middle of the room. Please, continue. Congratulations! This modified version of the device gives you the ability to place both tunnels. As fun, yet extremely deadly as this may be, please remember our motto. If your life is on the line, it's safety guideline time. That's not an official motto. I just made it up, but you get the idea. I'd love to hear your thoughts on these tests. Maybe you'll want to do the post-testing interview after all this? Have a reason to blink. The engineers kind of just added it so I can connect better with test subjects. Also, mainly to discourage test subjects from shooting me with a tunneling device. Thank you. what? You're the only test subject I've met so far, but you sure are a great one.
Welcome to Level 7.
before you and wait, watch out for gun.
Welcome to
you're okay.
Alright,
let's
see.
Careful!
Thank you.
next two chambers test you on everything you've learned so far. Don't worry, you can do it. Great job! Only one more to go.
Thank you.
Maybe there's power maintenance today. It's okay, we'll just wait a bit. See? What did I say?
Ah! What? This isn't part of the test? Grab onto something!